Are you overwhelmed by all the possible bowing techniques on the violin? And do you have no idea where to start? Or do you just want to know those 6 basic violin bow strokes you need in 95% of the repertoire? And guess what? If you learn these 6 bow techniques, then you can easily learn the other dozens of bow techniques that there are out there, because they are practically derived from them, or combinations of them, or nuances of them. In this video, I will explain those 6 basic bow strokes with repertoire examples and etudes, so you can start practicing and mastering them already. You don't have to frantically take notes of them, because in the description below, I will link to an overview of all the pieces that I mentioned and free sheet music download, so you can really get started with this. The default bowing is called détaché, which actually means separated. And that refers to that you just play one note on one bow stroke and you play the notes in their full length. And actually, if you don't see anything in the sheet music notation, then you need to use this default way of bowing. Now, what I just played is an easy beginner concertino in the first position, and that's by Kuchler. It's his Opus 11, and the free download is in the description underneath. The second basic bow stroke is staccato. Mostly people do it wrong because they do all kinds of other things. Well, staccato is actually the opposite of tenuto, and tenuto is practically the détaché. Tenuto means in full length. Staccato means not playing the notes in full length. And that's really it. It's also character in music. But certainly in the beginning, what you learn is to stop the bow. So play a note, then you have some silence, then you play the next note. But apart from that, it's completely the same as détaché. It's just and I explain it in a way that like you would play a video of yourself playing détaché, and you just stop the video, you just pause it at each bow change. Bow, stop. Bow, stop. And in that way you can play the notes in half their length and create this really separated effect. Now, the beginner etudes that I always recommend are the books by Wolfart, and I'll provide you with a free sheet music download in the description. And even in Wolfart number 1, you can already apply détaché and staccato versus. Alright? So, what a lot of people do wrong in staccato is that they make accents. Or that they make a belly bowing, so not a consistent bow speed. It's, by the way, also a mistake that people make in détaché. Sounds very tiring if you do. So try to have consistent weight on your bow and a consistent bow speed. So in staccato, you really just stop after bow stroke. You don't go faster and then slower or something, because then you get a little bit of belly bowing. Stroke that you will learn is martelé. This is just as staccato, also a bow stroke where you don't play the notes in their full length, but the bow technique is slightly different, because in martelé you catch the string making an accent. So you catch the string with your index finger, you have pressure on your index finger, then you can move around the string a little bit without sliding the bow over it. So you know you've caught the string, and I know it's really hard to show, but you can then move around a string without bowing, so to say. And then when you start a bow stroke, you suddenly release this pressure and create a clicking sound. So you hear ta, ta, and not la, la, like we heard in détaché. Now, after you release it, you let the bow travel. And you have to prepare each bow stroke by catching the string with your index finger. Now, a great piece to practice this is the Indian Concertino by Perlman. And great etudes to practice, Accents and Martelet, are Wolfhard numbers 12 and 21. And that etude book is available for free if you follow the link in the description. The fourth important bow technique is legato, and this is the first bow technique where you play several notes on one bow stroke. You see in the sheet music a slur above the notes. That means that you must play all these notes on one bow stroke. Piece to practice legato is reading Opus 35, which is also an easy beginner concertino, all in the first position. And the free sheet music is in the link in the description of this video. Very beautiful piece, by the way. What's challenging for violin students if they learn legato is that you have been drilled from the beginning to play like one note, one bow stroke, and this can really mess up your brain, so to say. So really make sure that you start with just two notes on one bow stroke and just play simple scales. To really get used to several notes on one bow stroke. And you can then build it up to three notes on one bow stroke, four, etc., etc., etc. The fifth bow technique that you will learn is portato or lurée. They are the same. Portato is just Italian and lurée is French. What I refer to is, and you'll see it by dots above or below the notes, and then also a slur. But it doesn't mean legato, because in portato, you must really separate the notes. You do play them in their full length, but usually it's on several of the same notes, and then if you play that legato, then you'll just hear one long note, so to say. So what you need to do is just stop the bow just for a tiny moment. That is portato. You can do it in two ways, so with stops, or by really drawing the bow but just giving accents with your index finger. And this gives a different sound effect. And I explain a bit more in my video on the parlando bow technique, so you'll really learn this difference. And a great example is My Heart Will Go On. And the third movement of the Küchler Concertino I mentioned before. And in that context, some call it also hooked bowing. The sixth bow technique is a simple spiccato, and that's maybe something that you'll learn a little bit later on if you've developed some experience with the other bow techniques. Now, spiccato is an off-the-string bow technique, which means that we lift the bow off the string. Also, it's a semi-passive bow technique, the first one, and that means that you use the natural bouncing of the bow. So you make a U-shape with your wrist and fingers. And you play a little bit above the balance point of your bow. Now, the balance point of your bow is where the bow is equally heavy on both sides. It can be a little bit different for your bow than it is for my bow. So you play a little bit above that, and that's where you get that natural jump in this tempo the best. So eventually it looks like. Now, don't worry if it takes you a while to really learn a good spiccato. You can approach it from two different angles. First is the active bowing angle, and that is that you really make this put down spiccato U-shape, and then really make sure that you do this with your fingers. And you must first be able to do that in a simple détaché stroke. If that's still a challenge for you, then really stick to the other bow techniques at the moment. But if you've mastered that, then you can move to lifting the bow off the string. It does help if you tilt the bow a little bit. So if you tilt the stick in the direction of the scroll, This one is great to practice. Another approach is that you don't go from active to semi-passive, but from passive to semi-passive. And that means that you will start by just dropping the bow. And certainly if you've been practicing really hard to get bow control, then this can feel scary and you might be even be scared to drop the bow. And just see how the bow reacts when you drop it. Try to follow the bow movement with your wrist and fingers. So you're not actively doing it, you're just trying to move along with this energy. See how the bow bounces. So you can experiment with that, and that's really helpful in learning spiccato. Now make sure you first master these bow techniques in open string exercises, then in slow scales, then in etudes, and then apply them in pieces. What I just played is the concertino in the style of Mozart by Millis, and that is a great concertino to apply all these bow techniques in, because you'll see them all. And a great etude, if you want to combine all these bowing techniques, is Mazas number 2, and I'll also link that Mazas book in the description. Now, if you are a little bow technique nerd like me and you want to learn all bow techniques, then make sure to watch this video of me where I explain them all with examples and notation in the sheet music. As a bowing coach, I've helped hundreds of one-on-one students and tens of thousands of YouTube subscribers to overcome their technical struggles and really pour their hearts out in their music. If that's what you want, then subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I hope to see you in the next lesson. Bye-bye.